September 17th, it's about 2:40 p.m. It reads about 96 degrees out here. We put the little sprinkler out there so the hummers can go through there. They're like flying through that water. And we've moved it back and forth. It seemed like there's not a pressure like it had been. But it would just barely hit the leaves over there, and it would hit the leaves over here on this other tree. And they would fly through that, and they fly up in the tree and such. But they do like that water. They'll go through it. And I'm going to go over here to the garden. First, I'm going to go by the side of the house where we planted a couple of tomato plants. You know, if this battery doesn't wear out, because this is a piece of junk Sony. And when I zoom in and out, it just wears the battery down so fast. Let's see here. It's fogging up. And I can't see anything out here in the sun. There's a tomato plant there, all out, and there's flowers on there still. This one here. Got two tomatoes on here, one on the other one my wife took off yesterday or this morning. I don't remember. Here's three. These were suckers, if you know what a sucker is. We put them in water for about a month and a half, and they had long, long roots. And I put a part of a bag that was open already, and part of that one right there of garden soil in there, and watered them. I don't see now. This is the one that the tomato came off of right here. There's a little toad down there by the. You can see him right there. If I move, yeah, it's okay. Anyway, I use string. I mean, people laugh about it, but you know, here, this is just have it hanging down. Out here, because this is where the shed was that the tornado took off. You can still see some of the screws are still stuck up. That's where it was nailed, screwed down into this platform. And then the wind took it and tornado threw it into that tree up there. So it was like an F1 tornado. Just want to show you how these are. Because they're too close, because we didn't know how long, how well they would grow out. Look at all the tomatoes, though. See all those tomatoes? They're all over this plant. I've been out here trying to sucker them and get the worms off them. If you know what a hornworm looks like, look it up. See, like right here, with one hand, I'm not going to do it no more because I've been doing it before and I end up tearing up the stems and all that. That's a sucker. It's right. See what's right in the bend in the middle? You pull that off. When I get about this size, even if you put in water like we did with those other three, there, you see how they grew? Those will become tomato plants. It is September, but with the heat being like it is, it might grow into late October. Of which it may produce some tomatoes from those others, but I doubt it. But, yeah, I'm just looking at all the tomatoes, and that's one plant. And there's another one. You can see how it's all spread out. All kind of little tomatoes. And I mean, I've been out here usually around 6-ish in the morning, and around 6:30 in the evening. And you just look for hornworms. And when you see, you'll see sometimes, you'll see like little piles of poop. It's like little dots down there. Looks like piles of dirt. It's poop from these earth hornworms. Some of them have done damage already, if I can find a branch to show it. Because like I said, we've been out here and killing them. We get one, averaging about one every day or two. After checking it twice. But they get on here and they'll devour the leaves. Like I said, I can't see really good out here with this. Holding the camera in one hand and trying doing this, but you know, like here's a kind of like this. You see how this is? You see how bare it is? But there's still a couple leaves on here. But all this right here, see this one looks like it was. And here, this is a perfect example. See how that is? And that right there? That's what they'll get on there and they'll devour it. They will. Oh, right here. Here's a big one. See him right there? Okay, I'm gonna slice him in half. This is what I do with these things because, you know, they're no good for anything. Where's he at? Oh, right there he is. I'm not going to show it on thumbnail. Just cut them in half because that's what they're good for. Cut in half. That was a big one. But you see what he was doing? How he was devouring this one? See how it's all blank right here. All the leaves were eaten off it. Otherwise, it should look like this right here. See all these leaves? And you see that, how bare it is? That's what they do. And like I said, if I hadn't, you know, see how big it was too, he's over there cut in half. I'm not gonna go back on them. But now that's the first one that big in a long time. We have gotten a bunch of them, not quite that big, but pretty good size. And then we've just been getting a bunch of little ones, because, you know, they're getting by. Here's another one. See that one right here? Again, I can't see on there. Right here, I'm gonna take him off. And he's gonna get sliced in half. Because, you know, that's what we do. Because they ain't good for anything. I don't know if you can fish with something like that. But that's two. Okay, that would be about average. That would be a bit, maybe this evening we'll check again, see if there's one or two out here. But there was two good, one was a big one, and the other one there was good size, but it was not real big. So, they'll decimate these. See the stems here. See all the leaves, how they are. Look at these here, see how them leaves are? And then you see that one right there. So it was feeding, one was feeding on there. I got that one, I think it was down here somewhere. But that's a hornworm. And they're in the ground. They say they get in the ground, they lay dormant. I'm like, great, you know, we can't keep taking this plastic up and tilling it up. That's the only way you're supposed to do it to get rid of them. But it practically killed us to get that plastic back down in the back out there. And we took up all three of them, one, two, and three. Number two isn't growing crap. Nothing over there is growing any good. So I don't know if we're going to leave plastic over there and just take it up and leave it and not plant anything there. Or maybe leave the plastic down and plant beans in it. And that's it, just beans that crawl across the plastic. But it's hot out here. I'm going to get that knife there and get this one here. Put this one in the back garden by number three. Yeah, I see the tomatoes here. See how much damage one did? See how bare all this is? You know, one that got off there a couple days ago. Otherwise, like I say, it should always be leafy like this. Everything can be full of leaves. When you see a stem and there's no leaves or a couple leaves only on there, you look real close and you'll see a worm. And you get them off. And with this heat, I don't know if that makes them more active or not. There's one, two, three, four down there. Look at all the, look at